Hi boys and girls, Miss Cody here again. Today we're gonna have a lot of fun doing a couple of different activities. Showing below you right now on this video are the materials that you're gonna need from your music kit or things that you can get from home. So for example, if I said that you needed rhythm sticks, you can use two pencils or some wooden spoons or anything else like that in order to do along our activity if you don't have your rhythm sticks at home with you. Same thing if you have you don't have the paper plates or the plastic plates that I gave you in your music kit, you can go ahead and find your own paper or plastic plates within your house or just use your hands. So have fun, make sure you have all your materials, pause the video right now to go and get them if you need to, and then you can continue on with our activities. Sometimes you might just need your Chromebook because I might be sending you to a website in order to do an activity there. Have fun.
Make new friends, but keep
make
the
new
old.
Friends, but keep
the
new
old.
But
the
silver on the
other
friends, but keep
the
old. Friends,
but
make
the
silver
on the
with your partner.
Get your partner. We're ready to do Sasha. Remember, start with your right hand, the one opposite from where your heart is. Turn and face your partner.
Face your partner. Here we go. Sasha.
Sasha. Rast, va, pri. Right, right, right. Left, left, left.
Right elbow
elbows.
Swing. Left elbow swing.
Hands.
Find another partner.
Here we go in your circle. Make sure you find another partner or switch sides. Switch sides with me. Okay, I'm ready. Start with your right hand.
Spaces starring Guido D'Arezzo and his friend.
Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face.
In the space.
Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face. Don't you forget it. Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face.
In the space.
Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face. Don't you forget it. Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face.
In the space.
Every good boy does fine.
I'm alive.
F-A-C-E face.
Hi, boys and girls. Today we're going to begin learning how to read music on the staff. Not like a shepherd's staff, but a musical staff. Learning to read music is really awesome because no matter what country you're from, you read musical notation the same. In fact, some people call music the universal language. For instance, if I had a piece of flute music, I would read it and play it the same as someone from Italy or China would because the musical alphabet is the same. Music can connect us when speaking, reading, and writing cannot. That's some pretty powerful stuff. A musical staff has 5 lines, and in between the 5 lines are 4 spaces. We also need a clef, which can be one of these musical symbols. Treble clef is for higher notes, like a flute would play, or a soprano would sing. And bass clef is for lower sounding instruments and voices, such as a tuba, or a baritone singer.
Now I feel so good, yeah.
Depending on what clef you choose, the notes will be different even if it's on the same line or space. For today, we're going to stick with the treble clef. The lower the line or space on the staff, the lower the pitch. The higher the line or space, the higher the pitch. Starting from the bottom of the treble clef staff, the lines represent the notes E, G, B, D, and F. The letters always remain in this order from the bottom line to the top line of the staff. A trick you can use to help you remember the names of the lines is assigning a word to each letter, such as every good boy deserves fudge.
Nom, nom, nom.
Or you can choose to use something else, such as Eddie's green boots don't fit, or empty garbage before dad flips. Even something like everyone gets balloons during fiestas. It doesn't matter which one of these sayings you pick to help you, as long as you remember it. I've always used every good boy deserves fudge, so that's what I'm going to continue to use. Let's do some practice rounds. Which note is this? I can see that it's not on the first, second, or third line, but it's on the next line, our fourth line. So if we stop at the fourth line of our phrase, every good boy deserves. Deserves starts with a D. That means that note is the letter name D. Let's do another one. Can you figure out this note? This one's not on our first line, but it's on the second line, so we can just stop there. We go to the second word of our phrase, every good. Good starts with a G, so this note is a G. Try this last one by yourself. If you got F, then you got it correct. Good job. Now that you know how to figure out the notes on the lines of the treble clef staff, what do we do for the spaces? Well, there's four spaces, so we're going to assign a letter to each space on the staff. F for the first space, A for the second space, C for the third space, and E for the fourth and final space. Hey wait, that spells face. As long as you remember the word face, which rhymes with space, you'll be good to go. Let's get some practice with naming our notes on a space. How about this first one? Can you figure out what this note is? Well, going from bottom to top, our note head is not in the first space, but it's in the second space. We don't have to keep going. Since it's in the second space, what's our second letter of face? A. Let's try another one. Going from bottom to the top, what space is this in? Not in the first, not in the second space, not in the third, but it's in the highest space, the fourth space. What's our fourth or last letter in the word face? That's right, you got it, E. Try this last one by yourself. Did you get it? If you guessed C, you'd be correct. Nice work. Woo-hoo! Let's talk about what we learned so far. We know that musicians write music on a staff to know what note to sing or play. We know that we can have different clefs on the staff, such as treble or bass clef, but today we only talked about treble clef. We also learned that there are two types of notes, notes on a line or notes on a space. In fact, there are five lines and four spaces on our staff. If they're on a line, we used the saying, every good boy deserves fudge, to remind us that the notes from the first line up to the fifth line are E, G, B, D, and F. For spaces, we used the word face to help remind us that the spaces from the bottom up to the top space are F, A, C, and E. Now that we reviewed, take a moment or two to figure out these six notes. Be careful. These notes could be on a line or a space now. You'll have to look at them extra carefully. Here are the answers. How did you do?
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. My world's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Boys and girls, we're going to do some more with tongue twisters since you guys seem to have so much fun with them. This is another favorite of mine. It's Fuzzy Wuzzy. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy wuzzy. Let's try it again slowly. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy, was he? Try a little bit faster now. Ready? Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy, was he? Try to go a little faster, boys and girls. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy, was he? Let's go as fast as we can. Ready? Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy, was he? Can you go that fast? Try it one more time with me. Here we go. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy, was he?
Trees. Wow. Echoed two other voices.
What was that?
Asked Freddy.
It sounded like an elephant trumpet,
said Eli.
Look!
Freddy pointed above the trees. A flock of birds was flying in big circles in the sky. The birds kept going around and around and around.
What are they doing?
Eli said.
Andante!
Called the deep voice.
Andante!
Andante? What does that mean?
Freddy asked Eli. Suddenly, the birds dove through the trees. Then Freddy and Eli heard. Eli thumped his huge feet with a steady beat.
Shh,
Freddy said.
Listen.
Eli stopped thumping and lifted his ears. Now they heard someone chanting a catchy rhythm. Freddy's webbed feet began to wiggle and kick. He couldn't keep them still. Then his whole body broke out into a dance. What kind of island was this? The deep voice roared suddenly. Everything stopped, even Freddy and Eli. Then the two friends entered the jungle.
We've got to find out who's making this music,
Eli said. The elephant call sounded again.
Whoa. Wow.
Up went the birds, circling and circling.
Allegro!
Called the deep voice.
Allegro!
Again, the birds dove through the trees, and the same beat began, but faster. Eli could not resist thumping the beat. Freddy crouched between Eli's ears, listening. Would there be another rhythm? Freddy yelled,
"Let's boogie!"
He kicked his skinny legs, flung his arms, and swung to the rhythm. Called the deep voice. The music stopped. As Freddy and Eli forced their way through the trees and bushes, they heard the trumpeting again.
Whoa. Wow.
Up soared the birds. Down fell Freddy.
Let it go.
Down dropped the birds. The bassline beat thumped slowly. Freddy scrambled back on top of Eli just before Eli's feet began pounding the ground. Freddy liked this rhythm. He bounced his shoulders and kicked his feet. He chanted too.
Tika tika ta! Tika tika ta! Tika tika ta! Tika tika ta!
Everything stopped. Eli and Freddy pushed aside a huge leaf. They found the colorful bird sitting on the head of a purple elephant. And Freddy and Eli saw a bobaloo baboon and an orangutan.
Whoa!
The purple elephant trumpeted.
Wow!
Echoed the bobaloo baboon and the orangutan. The birds dropped to the ground, picked up sticks, and hovered over the trio.
Presto!
Presto!
The purple elephant began thumping a fast beat on his upright bass. The birds swooped down and laid their sticks in a pattern. They were playing a game! Chanted the bobaloo baboon. The orangutan's large hands slapped the rhythm on a drum. Freddy and Eli imitated the trio, but the two friends didn't notice the ground crumbling under Eli's pounding feet. Suddenly, the sandy bluff gave way, and Freddy and Eli tumbled down. They landed right in the middle of the animals.
Miss Goosey,
said the purple elephant.
Excuse me?
Eli said.
Make a fish?
Asked the purple elephant. Freddy scratched his head.
Tikka 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 tikka!
Twittered the birds. Freddy talked slowly and used hand motions.
I'm Freddy and this is Eli. Eli and I live on Treble Clef Island.
May we join you?
Asked Eli. The animals and birds just stared at him. They did not understand. Then Eli had an idea. Eli raised his small trunk and trumpeted with all his might.
Wahoo!
Wahoo!
Responded Freddy. Eli thumped a slow, largo beat. The island creatures smiled. Music! They understood! The birds quickly laid a new rhythm on the ground. Freddy danced and chanted,
Ti-ti-ti-ti-ta! Ta!
Ti-ti-ti-ti-ta! Eli thumped a little faster.
Ta! Ti-ti-ti-ti-ta! Ta!
Accelerando!
Exclaimed the purple elephant.
Accelerando!
Echoed all the others. The purple elephant plucked his bass, matching Eli's beat. The orangutan tang played the rhythm on his drum. And the babaloo baboon joined Freddy, chanting and dancing to the rhythm. The elephants increased the tempo to andante. Then, allegro. Began to slow the beat. Freddy led them in a conga line back to the other side of the island. Everyone stopped. They looked around at each other. Together they had made a great song. Then Freddy pointed to the raft pieces scattered over the beach.
Will you help us get home?
Freddy asked. He pointed to Treble Clef Island. The purple elephant, Babaloo Baboon, and Orangutan Tang nodded,
See! Wahoo!
Exclaimed the purple elephant.
Wahoo!
The rest of the animals shouted. They gathered the raft pieces, and the birds found vines to tie the wood together. As the new friends worked, they hummed their song.
Wow! Thanks!
Exclaimed Freddy.
That was fun!
He slapped the baboon a high five. Then Freddy and Eli paddled away from the island.
Ciao!
Called their new friends, waving goodbye.
Ciao!
Echoed Freddy and Eli. Freddy and Eli sang all the way home.
Ta ta, ti 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 ta ta.
Good one, Freddy.
All right, boys and girls, it's time for us to sing our goodbye song. So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. I said so long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. It's been great to play and sing together, but now it's time to say goodbye. So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. Bye, everybody.